Hey guys, this is Last Humans Quickie. Even when there's nothing going on, there's something going on, as you know. First off, remember I was talking about those dirty waxy hinges there. Got those pretty nice, pretty dialed in. You say, how the hell did I do that? A lot of stuff, 90% alcohol, which probably isn't great for this because the paint's a little thin. Like I might have seen some little weird things that wouldn't come off. I'd probably water down your alcohol maybe. I don't know if watered down was the same as making it 70% or not, or if there's some more scientific thing about that. But 90% alcohol might be a little harsh on the paint. I mean, I wouldn't use it on the exterior really, not too much. But as you can see with the toothbrush and the alcohol and the cracks and everything, pretty decent. You can't get under it. This is the worst spot on all the cars because everything drops down. So in there, that's pretty dang clean. I haven't finished the other side yet. I did a little bit here. I mean, they're pretty dang nice, but it was too hard to get to. I didn't like spend hours on this side, but this one's just so easy to get to. I didn't peel off that bit of oil on the edge there, but overall, and these, like this stuff down there didn't seem to really come off, those weird marks and stuff. So I think the paint's just so thin there that the alcohol might have messed up the paint, but overall it looks pretty good. Just working on small little rattle things. The door thing has just been, like, I don't think the all this pillar work completely solved it. So I've been wanting to open this door for a while, and I can't see a lot, to be honest. Everything's tight. I think I just saw something. What I'm about to do anyway is I'm gonna take out this dumb plastic piece. There's no reason, I mean, there's some reason, I guess. There's no real reason for it. Maybe to fill a hole or to keep water out of somewhere. I don't think so, because there's holes everywhere. This plastic piece is a really weak point for noise. And I just saw the harnesses with the little vibrations and door stuff. It could be going against that plastic tab. I mean, I just want to eliminate this hole, even here, look. The clips aren't tight enough, even here. That's why they got foam there, see that? Because they know what makes noise. I think this plastic piece could be all the noise. It's still gonna be structurally decent. This plastic is not adding much structural or integrity to this metal door. This could be the noise that a lot of people hear with the slight vibrations because it's a crappy design. So it looks like it's just three pop pins. I'm gonna go ahead and try those and just pop this thing off, put it all back together. Nothing else is loose. Everything's solid. Everything's wrapped. And it always seemed to came from here. This is close to where it might have come from. So there's a chance here. There's a chance here. The door is still pretty solid, as you remember from long time ago. Oh, I mean, I didn't even mention the Dynamat. Of course, if you watch my channel for a while, you know that. The plastic sheet's long gone. Dynamat inside and out, inner and outer doors, all that crap. Even the door panel. And I'm trying to land these really important speakers that I've been searching for a long time. And I don't even want to say anything and jinx it, and I may not get them. But they've been like out of build, out of whatever you call it, manufacturer for like 10 years. Something just popped up and I'm trying to get it. If I do, then you'll hear about it. It depends how much money I want to waste and fight people over to get that really holy grail unicorn thing that I'm looking at. I don't even want to say more. I don't want anybody competing. All right, you'll see about that later if it happens. So, okay, let me get a panel popper. Take care of this right now. Mosquitoes. Oh, these tiny little mosquitoes. God damn it. Where's my electrocution tennis racket? I seriously think this could be the source of a lot of people's door rattle, man. This plastic piece of junk. What the hell is it, for sound waves? I seriously doubt it. It could be an integrity thing for the door, but dude, this is metal with all my Dynamat. Screw that. I'm gonna leave that out. You can see all it did was kind of patch these three together. If you really want to do it right, you know, you bolt a metal bar there or something. Really solid, not a plastic thing with clips that's gonna rattle against all of your pieces. So just since I'm here, I may shove some foams behind some of these that aren't protected foam like this. just against some of these points, and then I'm gonna go ahead and put this back together without this piece of crap that Subaru put foam protectors on, which are kind of shrunk down. You can see now they're worn. Maybe that's where the noises start. They get crushed after a while. They used to be nice and thick, like that inside section. Then they get crushed flat like that. Hell yeah, are you kidding me? This is probably my door noise. So I was just getting a pile of my junk. Let's see, I have a tube, just some foam, some mini foam, which isn't so great, but hey, it works. So the first thing I do is, it might be a little thick, and it'll be all right. That's what it's for. So I'm putting a nice piece here, right at that touch point that it used to tap a little bit. That foam ain't going, I can make it next one shorter. Anything else that's close? Not really, that thing is pretty far out. Everything here, I might just run a rag on the bottom of that door while I'm at it. Nothing else really, it's all pretty secure. This thing is soft. This thing is pretty soft. It's not gonna make too much rattle. It's mostly these plastic things and things like that. That's pretty good right there, no looseness. This could have been one of them right there, right about where it came from. And of course these door things, maybe they may make noise, but they're, I mean, you can't do everything. And these do have a nice bit of foam on them. All right, hell, I think that's probably about it. Maybe something on here too, protect both of these that are on this swivel here, so both sides aren't gonna click. Maybe something like that. Something else that may be a lot easier for you. These damn caps always get loose and they tap. This one's getting loose. Imagine that vibration. I've been meaning to order a bunch of caps forever. This isn't uncommon. Look at this, the rear one. The rear one always is sticking up. These caps that hide the screw. See, it's all screwed up. I'm gonna order 4 new caps too that have a proper, this doesn't even lock down anymore. Total junk. And all this vibrations could be tapping. I didn't check the other side. I'm gonna break open that other door and do the same plastic removal, but I won't show you that. This one's okay. Maybe in reality they do make the tap even when they're in. I could easily solve that with a little piece of electrical tape too. But I do want, and this one is, no, this one's solid, see? This one's the best one, brand new almost. No tap on this one. I think I'm gonna order 4 of those too, for good measure.